Okay, so here we are back. Next part. Continue working on the interior for this car. I went and got some more reference images, so now I know what the inside of this part looks like. So that will help me better when working on it. So for now, I can delete this. And I can even rotate this part up. Also, let me see before I delete that. I want to, let's see, do it from top view. I just want to fix the spacing a little bit. Not too much. So that way, when I duplicate it over, there's, a reasonable amount of space. Even stuff pops up. So yeah, that should be fine. Also, that side selected, I'm just going to deselect. These verts. Over here, so that I can raise it up a bit. Let's see if sculpting this helps. Let me isolate. Selected. Whoops, wrong viewport. Okay, so I'm gonna isolate selected. Let's see if I can relax. So I'm using the smooth brush. So I'm using the relax brush now, just try to relax some of this. So I'll isolate selection again. Too much. So yeah, just using the relax brush to try to just relax some of it. And of course, keeping this, I can see this part on the inside. Like, I can easily just make a piece to fit for there. And this part should come up. Come forward a bit. Because you see, most of that part is covered. So this covering actually comes on top of it. Let's see. Use this grab brush. Try to move it. Let's change its brush from the left side. So, if you, wait, I don't know what this is. That's weird. This is the right, and I should be viewing it from this side, which means I'm gonna turn off the image plane. Start moving it. So I'm just sliding the edge. Of course, I'm not worried about this side because I'm going to mirror it over. I really want to fix this end gun. Okay, that's good. Although I don't really understand all this up here. One, two, three, four. That. So just mirroring it over, merging it, delete history. Okay, let's try sliding. Okay, before that, I'll try fixing this part right here, smoothing it before I mirror it over. Delete history. Okay, so make sure there's no history left on this. And now, I wanted to put an edge loop here. So I'm manually inserting an edge. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So yeah, that's fine. Wonder if I bevel this part. Let's try filling this whole thing right here. Try another bevel. Okay, this is unnecessary for the right there. Okay, so let's see what we can do with this part. I'm just going to connect this there. I connect that there. Okay, so what I just did was just pretty much scaled it in. Move this back over to the center. That should allow me. To slide this. So yeah, I'm like just smoothing around this part right here. So I'll just merge that for now. And as far as this piece goes. think I need to move this forward a bit. This forward a bit. For this part, I need to move this up a bit more. Okay, I'm gonna use some of the scale tools, I should say. Let's try moving some of this up a bit. So of course I'm making this area bigger after. Looking at it further in some parts. So of course this needs is way too long. You can already see. Should probably stop. Not only the long, but I think the height too. I think the height needs to come down a bit. So try getting another view. So yeah, like it doesn't, this part isn't as high, this curve right here. And this part extends a little more, so I'm just going in and making some corrections. So this part should be like right here. Just give it a nice curve. So I deselect it from this side. Just let's see. Yeah, just try to smooth it a little bit. For this part, I'm just gonna move it forward, extend it up a bit. Move this part forward and extend it up a bit. Okay, so Let's get a listen. Just a little bit. Or no, like I'll fix that later. As for this part, definitely gonna put an edge loop right here. And work back the curve that it had. So let's see, see if I can just add a little bevel in there. Okay, fix the side. And then try to bevel it. Okay, so it's not poking out really weird. So for this part, I'm thinking of smoothing it. Its history, and then using a lattice deformer. Okay, that fits. Now, for this part, okay, so yeah, just a matter of fixing this edge. So what I'm gonna do is delete that part from right there so that it's not pulling. And this part right here. So yeah, you can see this part's coming along. So now, as for this up here, can start with these faces, I think should be it. Yeah. So, first extrude, scale that extrusion in, because I wanted this edge right here. I'm going to extrude again, scale a little bit, but push in, scale a little bit, extrude again. you know, pulling just to give it some space. And of course, it's smooth here. I mean, I could go in, so get that part. Oh, first, what do I need to do? I need to try to smooth out this area. So, of course, a nice bevel. Yeah, that seems to do the trick. So it's just a matter of, you know, closing it up. So, put it on. So yeah, from here to here, straight down the middle. Gives me four sides, so that's perfect. So I'll do that. Undo. Okay, there it is. Can be a little tricky. Sometimes you gotta zoom in and compare both sides. Then it's like, you know, I can see where the difference is. And of course, selecting this ring. And I'm probably gonna bevel that too, just to make that a bit smoother. Okay, so now I have a space for the air vent, which is basically a mini version of what I did up here, except it's a whole piece, so it's like I'll have to, I can take these and move them over there, like duplicate them, which is most likely what I'm going to do, but then I still need to create like the piece that they fit into, so I might duplicate the face around and bring that over as well. So let's see, Control D. Control G. Center's pivot. Move these three over. Also want to make sure I go into my outliner. Okay, so just to check, so that group is also, yeah, I don't want it to be grouped in with the rest of these, so just keeping it separate. Of course, it would have been better if I used my orthographic view, then I could move it properly into place. So, yeah. So this is going to be here. Let's see. Okay. Should be good enough. And we go back to this group. And change the group's pivot and move that to the center. I'm gonna keep it the same. Okay, so now I have that area. I'm going to, if you didn't guess already, duplicate it. Scale it just so I can see it. And just move that up a bit. So now I can. Okay, so I need to adjust it a bit. Okay, so that seems to be going well. Let me just fix this. Whoops. So now I should be able to. And there you go. It's not completely exact, but yeah, like I said before, I wasn't going for the exact thing. I was trying to get close enough. Okay, let's take this group. Let's pivot over. This transformation duplicate special, and there we have. This part can come back a little more. Okay. need to just move this over a tad. So yeah, a lot of it's coming along nicely. Just wanted to tackle one area over here. So you can't see it from this image, but you can see it here. The bottom of it kind of raises up to hold the chairs, so. Of course, instead of extruding up, I'll just extrude down. with this. Smooth it some more. Okay, so with that extrusion, then I'll bring it down. Those I just selected, I'm gonna try beveling that. Seriously? Okay, let's see how smooth this goes. it. Did I miss a piece? So to explain what happened here is basically there were some faces that were protruding into each other. And that's basically for like the center of the seed. So I just need to correct that. So now the seed starts to look a bit more like how it should. So now that I've pretty much got it to look the way I want it to look, then I can just subdivide it. And with that subdivision, I can go in and just start trying to see if I can brush out some areas. Yeah, you see, it starts to look just like the picture. You start to get a feel for it. Now, of course, want to duplicate that and move it forward into this space, deleting this now. The back seat and step back seat two. Put the one and put front seat. Go back to our naming conventions. Now, of course, I have to modify this seat bit so that it will match, because the front seat obviously has a lot more to it compared to the back seat. So let's see. This. Yeah. As you can see, it's like a panel. Yeah, so yeah. What I could do is just delete this whole side, which is what I might do, and just create another piece to slide in there. I don't know. Right now, it doesn't seem to be too much of an issue. Let's see if. Okay, reducing it is definitely not gonna solve it. See, right now with this set of videos, I'm trying to keep it to Maya. So let's see what we can do about this. I have to isolate this. Let's see. So I'm using the grab brush right now. Chicken back here. Okay. So keeping up this area. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna go ahead and delete this back part. Okay, this is just, whoops. Don't quite get why I didn't select everything that I wanted it to, but yeah, just checking around, make sure everything. Especially this is good because then I can create extra parts if needed. Let's see. The bevel. It doesn't matter on that side, but whatever. Let's see what we can do with this area. Well, it looks like that fixes that. And of course. Okay, that was weird. Do that again. Merge, delete the history this time. Duplicate. Okay, so with this, It's weird. Why is okay? It's I don't get what's going on with this piece, though. Try moving it out of the group. Okay, so because it was grouped with this, it was affecting its rotation. So maybe now if I still know. Let me freeze its transformations and then try it again. I realized where the problem was coming from. Oh gosh, I didn't even realize I duplicated it so much. This transformation. Let me isolate this. history. Merch. Number three, so all of it together, call this front chair 01. Formations. It's history. Rename that cheer underscore. What is it like? I guess it's like a flip down disc. So I'll put like a flip desk. One. I'll label this front chair back 01. So you have front seat. Oh, shit. Should label it same seat. Front seat back 01. And I guess when I labeled this, anyway, front seat desk 01. So we have the desk part that comes out the back, and then the actual front of the seat. All this is still under the chairs. So I'm going to add that into the chair group. Oh, that's selected. I'm going to throw that into a group, so that's all of it. Of course, I need to fix the bottom here. probably putting some railings for when the front seat slides, because, you know, in the car, you can slide the seat forward to adjust it for the driver as well as the passenger side. So, you know, to help with that. So let's see, right now, like, I really just sat here and put in a lot of work. I mean, this is a pretty long video. It's okay, because, you know, we're making progress. Am I even... Yeah, I'm going to definitely lower this part too. But yeah, there's definitely going to be some more changes to the inside and outside of the car. As you can see, it's still coming along nicely. And so far, we've made some progress in multiple areas and multiple fixes to get this almost matching what it should. Can do a little bit more. So yeah, just minor changes in there, fixes. But definitely this interior is starting to come along. So with that, you already know. Save. You always want to make sure you save so that your files are there. But yeah, I don't really have to worry too much with the autosave on, and you know, can always have save in increments. So yeah, with that, I'm gonna call this video for now. Stay tuned for the next part. And don't forget to like and subscribe and show this to other people and have them like and subscribe as well. That helps out a lot. And, you know, stay tuned for more videos. So let me just make sure I save one more time. And that's it.